Sometimes I sleep with a sound machine or a fan. I started it in college to drown out my loud roommates, but now that I've read this research, I'm probably gonna quit. Sup, sleepers. Trace here for DNews. Sound machines are very popular with adults, especially in noisy urban environments, because they can use that white noise or rain to drown out other sounds. A new study in pediatrics found, however, that some infant sound machines can hit 50 decibels. A jackhammer is 95. 50 is loud, and since most adults keep them near the bed, they often do the same for their baby's infant model. Some of them even just hang right on the crib. Sound machines for babies are meant to drown out the extraneous noise and let both the babies and adults sleep uninterrupted. They create white noise, which is all the frequencies of sound the human ear can hear combined all together. It's like white light or black paint, but for sound. Some experts think it mimics what babies hear in the womb, and others look at how the brain processes something like noise versus tones or notes. The problem is that babies experience sound much more intensely than adults because their straighter, wider ear canal naturally amplifies sound. Plus, like in the Matrix, they've never actually used them before. So long-term exposure to 50 decibels or more could potentially be bad for a baby's hearing. Hearing is the ear and the brain working together to measure the waves of air pressure surrounding your body. The waves are perceived as sound and then measured in decibels. The human ear is very sensitive, registering sounds as loud as jet engines and as slight as just a pin dropping or hair brushing the skin. As our ears get used to the experience of sound, loudness can become less intense. I mean, we just get used to it. For instance, sound machines and fans make constant noise all night, and yet after a while, you kind of feel like you're in a quiet, soothing room. The reason we can sleep with something so loud firing across our eardrums all the time has to do with our brains. When you're in a loud, crowded place, you can hear one or maybe two conversations at once because your brain is great at using visual information combined with sound to pick out those voices. But if you stand on the edge of a crowded auditorium, it just kind of turns into a big blur. Even trying to pick out a voice can be tough. White noise is the same. With all those frequencies going at the same time, your brain just can't pick out the other sounds, and it just flat out ignores the whole batch. This doesn't translate to every situation, though. The National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health says ambient noise can increase stress levels, exacerbate high blood pressure, and cause stress-related problems like ulcers and headaches. And a study done with rats and published in Physiology and Behavior found white noise can affect the release of a stress hormone called cortisol. Rats exposed to white noise had 1.8 times more cortisol in their bodies. In humans, that would affect planning, reasoning, impulse control, and might even mess with short-term memory writing. Another study from the University of California, San Francisco found white noise might keep the brain from learning during sleep in children, delaying language acquisition and messing with hearing. If you have to use a sound machine to sleep, put it far away from where your baby sleeps, and maybe even from you for that matter. Keep the volume low and set the timer so that it doesn't drone on all night. Less exposure to the constant droning might be better for your brain and for your kids' brains. What's your sound machine? Fans, radiators, the furnace, air conditioners, dishwashers, or maybe you have an app on your phone. Let's talk about it down below and see if there is a better way than just constant noise. Be sure you subscribe for more DNews 7 days a week and toss us a like before you share with your friends. Thanks a lot for watching. Sleep well.